peace, everybody. This is Queenie Fama, and I am in the computer room at the African American Women's Center at the NCOBRA conference. So I just wanted to come here and do a little video about some of my thoughts about it so far, okay? So I guess the majority of you know what NCOBRA is. It's an organization that rallies around and fights for reparations for Black people here in America, okay? And I think they even have like extensions of it in other diasporas. But, you know, they had a question and answer period after the session, the first session today. And they were talking about, what we need to do as usual, you know, and all that. And so one of the brothers brought up the, you know, we need to have more Isusu economics. That's more like, you know, people pooling their money together and, you know, for a cause, you know, and that we should have co-ops. And so I was thinking, I'm like, we've already had those things. You know what I'm saying? We've tried those things. So my question is, you know, instead of keep doing it over and over and over, and we keep having the same failure rate, I'm like, why don't we, you know, kind of like critique the failure of these various, I'm talking about here in Wisconsin, so I really can't, you know, focus on everybody else, but I know how they failed here. So, you know, I'm like, why don't we critique the failure so that we don't keep repeating the same thing over every time we try to start something new, like another type of co-op or another type of, you know, initiative where we have to pool money together, you know, for whatever. But we need to look at why these things haven't been working, you know, before I will put my neck out on any of this stuff. You know, I want to know, okay, where did we fail in the past? And we have to be honest. You know, exactly what happened. Why didn't it work? Okay, so you know, that to me, that seems important that we examine the failure. Because the first thing was, oh, we gotta talk about the successes. If we had all them damn successes, we wouldn't even be talking about what we need, because it already be happening. Okay. It already be happening. So I think that the common sense thing to do to me is to critique the failures. Why did this not work? I mean, that's common sense in anything that we do. Anything that you do, you always look at it didn't work. You always look at why didn't it work? You know, and have an honest assessment, honest conversation about what happened, who dropped the ball. You know, you ain't got to name a person, but you could say, you know, from your experience being involved with it, what, you know, what happened. And then, you know, from that point, we make a commitment that won't happen again. If it failed again, it'll be for another reason, not for that same reason. But from what I'm seeing with these various initiatives is that we fail for the same damn reasons. Okay, but nobody wants to admit the reasons. They always want to talk about the successes. And I'm like, you ain't got no damn successes. That's why your ass is crying now. What success have you had outside of personal successes? But we steady complaining about the problems we have, and we this and we got this going on. And so where's the success? Let's be honest. You know what I'm saying? The queen is not into no feel good shit. I never have been. And I always want to look at what I've done wrong so I can do better. But it seemed like as a collective, we don't want to look at what we've done wrong, you know, and try to move forward and look better. Another thing I want to talk about too is, you know, joining these organizations. Like I told you, I've been quit joining organizations, and I'm going to give you another reason why, outside of the human bullshit that goes on in these organizations. I'm going to tell you another reason why, because the organization don't do shit for me. Okay, I mean, anytime, like if you go to Walgreens, they give you that little Walgreens card. I don't have it with, but they give you a little incentive card, right? So when you go to Walgreens, after so many times, you get points and you get some shit off, right? That's with all of these stores and businesses and things like that. You always get something, okay? You know, to patronize them. So I'm like, well, why? And I brought this up when I was on the membership committee for MBUF. And I was like, well, why don't we go around at least to the black businesses? Because I will do the work, but I'll be goddamn if I do the work by myself. I am not one who's a slave and wants a whole lot of accolades. I'm not like that. I'm saying we could do this together. But my suggestion was, is that, you know, we could pool our mental resources and maybe two or three of us, you know, form a committee and we go around to first black businesses. First of all, we got a black pages, so we could call those businesses in the black pages, maybe if we have to arrange a meeting with them or something, and ask them, could they offer a discount to MBUF members? Okay, and our members have a membership card, and when they patronize a black business, they get a percent. It could be just 10% off, okay? They get a percentage off of whatever they purchase at that particular store, all right? So I think that when you have a membership, when you have like these organizations that don't give people nothing, you have people that will still join them, but people join organizations that do nothing for them for various reasons, you know, like they just like to be a part of something, or they see the larger picture of the problem, so they want to put their efforts there. But see, that's why the organizations are always small, is because the organization doesn't offer them anything, you know. And if you look at the success of other organizations, it's always something that the organization gives people, whether it's free food, coals, or something. They give the people something. And so I think that's one of the biggest problems in black organizations, is that we have no incentive to stay, to remain in the organization. We may join it out of, you know, maybe a moment we get emotional and we want to join it, because I don't join stuff out of emotion too, you know. So we feeling all emotional, we want to join this organization and things like that. But after a while, the organization doesn't offer you anything. You know what I'm saying? And then you got to put up with all this bickering with the between memberships. You have to put up with the grandstanding and all that other kind of stuff that people do. So there's really no incentive for you to put up with that shit. That's all I'm saying. So, you know, and I'm just making a suggestion, you know, this is just an idea I have, that, you know, for those of you who are organizers and who are in these organizations, and maybe you can go around to even just the black business. You ain't even got to go to the A-Rap stores in your community or anything like that. But I guarantee you, they might even go for it too. But offer your members a percentage off or something, a discount or something. Just for say, I'm a member of such and such and such, and here's my membership card. And they say that you honor our membership, and that you're to give us a certain percentage off. Have that on the card. Okay, so, you know, and then maybe the owner could keep a tally of all the people, you know, the number of people that come in and use the card. That could be a number to say, hey, our membership is working, you know, blah, 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 blah. But these people want you to pay membership dues. Then if you have an event like a conference like this, they want you to work the conference to make it happen. They don't want to offer you shit off the conference fees. They want you to pay the whole conference fees. I mean, it gives you no incentive. It gives you no incentive. And we know, I mean, if we're honest, everybody wants to get something. You know what I'm saying? I mean, even the people, like I said, there's people who join for various reasons. They join for something, okay? So if we're talking about a mass of people, you got to give them something. You just can't expect them out of moral persuasion to join an organization because it's the right thing to do. No, you got to give people something, okay? That's the smart thing to do. You look, you got examples of that all around you. So, you know, as I sit at this conference and I just observe and listen to people, you know, like I said, I don't focus on the success. The success speaks for itself. I want us to critique the failure, because all the ideas that, you know, I know of are plausible. I mean, they make sense, like pooling your resources with each other, or, having memberships in these various organizations, things like that, they make sense to me. So I'm like, why don't we negotiate to try to get something for the members? You know, it's like these organizations take. They don't give nothing outside of their organizational name or fame or whatever. But that's why their memberships are low and stagnant and fluctuating, is because they have nothing and give nothing, no incentive to make you want to stay. I mean, if you even look at Marcus Garvey's UNIA, they gave the people something. Okay, these people give you nothing. They give you nothing. So, you know, I guess for all of those who are, you know, involved in these organizations, I suggest that, you know, maybe you should think about that. You know, I'm not trying to tell you what to do, but it only makes sense, you know, that you think about giving your members something. You all know, we got to do, get back to the community. We got to get back. What about your members, the people who sign up with you? And say, yeah, I want to be a part of this. What do you give them? All right. So with that said, this is Queenie Fama. I am the Truth Tears. I better get back in here to this conference. But I just had to break away to a quiet place so I can remember to you know, these thoughts. Because this is, you know, definitely what I've been thinking about as I sit. I got another whole day, you know. And I was looking around at the room and it's very sparse. You know, it's not a lot of people there. You know what I'm saying? I would say, from what they told me, it was like 30 people registered. I would say it's probably a little bit more because people registered yesterday. So I would say it might have been 40 registrations for this conference. And this is the national conference, okay? It should be hundreds of people here, at least 200 people here. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and people don't like for you to criticize, but, you know, that's what I do. I critique things. I think of things. You know, I think of how we could do it better, but I can't think of better unless I look at what you're doing wrong. So, but anyway, I was always one of those kids that like those puzzles that'll say, what's wrong in this picture? I could always pick out what's wrong. Didn't take long, okay? So anyway, this is Queenie Fama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everybody.